Hello, Scorpio. Welcome to Truth Well Told Tarot. This is Andrea, and I'm here to do your weekly tarot reading for the sign of Scorpio, Sun, Moon, Rising, and Venus, and it is from the 12th to the 18th of October 2020. So let's pull your first overarching message and see what we get. What do we have for Scorpio, please, angel spirits guides for the week? What is the overarching message? Thank you. The Fool. Message for Scorpio, please, angel spirits guides. What is... Okay, thank you. Thank you. So I have peace. And we have justice. Message for Scorpio, please, angels. What is the message that Scorpio needs to hear for the week? Thank you. 12th to the 18th of October 2020. What is the message that Scorpio needs to hear? Thank you. So we have Angel of Wisdom, pursue knowledge and spiritual growth. It might be for some of you, you're finding answers, getting information. We'll pull more cards. Okay. So I pull four cards, Scorpio, as you know. The first card is you, your current situation. The second card is your challenge. The third card is advice from spirit. And the fourth card is your outcome. And then we clarify the cards and go deeper into the message. And it won't resonate with everybody, so just take what resonates with you. First card out. Four of Pentacles. Eight of Pentacles is your challenge. The Devil is advice from spirit, and the Chariot is your outcome. Some similar cards to Cancer, actually. And we have Cancer right there. We also have Capricorn with the Devil. Let's see what else we get. What do we have, please, for Scorpio? Thank you. Can we clarify the cards on the table for 12th to the 18th of October 2020, please? Three of Swords, Scorpio. The Eight of Coins is clarified by the Eight of Swords. The Devil is clarified by the Four of Swords. And the Death card clarifies the Chariot. This is the card of Scorpio. Eight of Cups. So let's look at this Fool. I love the Fool energy because it's about optimism. It is about feeling good, anticipation, ready for the new, taking a dive, a leap of faith into a new path because you're ready to. The Fool carries very little baggage because he only takes what he needs on the journey. So there's nothing weighing down the Fool. So whatever this situation is, Scorpio, I definitely feel this week that there are reasons to be optimistic. You're ready to embrace the new beginning, a new path, a new start, starting over, call it what you will. There's liberation from what's gone with the Fool energy. It's a powerful new beginning, new chapter, call it what you will. Now we've got it with Justice. Now Justice is a card of doing the right thing for you, could be for all concerned. It can be to do with fairness. It might well be that something's happened that wasn't fair. There could have been some injustice that you suffered. Certainly with the Three of Swords and the cards that I can see on the table, it feels like Something's happened here that has caused some pain and hurt. This can be to do with the law as well, where there could be some legal association, could be to do with separations in terms of relationships, or if this hurt has been caused in the money and career aspect, could be tribunals or arbitration, settlements, that kind of thing. It could be also to do with the truth being on your side. Justice will prevail. You will get justice in whatever that means. Might be that there has been some decision or choice that has been made. Like I said, it could be either earthly justice or karma. It can be to do with a legal situation that is allowing you to just release and move forward now. So that might be happening for some of you this week too. It's actually bringing in peace for you. And that's why the Fool is here, because I've made peace with what's gone. I'm ready for the new. I'm not carrying anything with me. I've completely liberated from it and I'm moving forward. It's a wonderful card, the peace energy, because it just feels like there's no attachment of toxicity or old cords that need to be cut. You've made peace with this situation and you're moving forward. It feels like this justice is bringing in peace, in whatever that means for you. Now, it might well be, like I said, you might be finding some information this week. It might well be that you're finding the answers for spiritual growth. This could be you reconnecting to who you are and finding answers and how you need to take action towards a new beginning, a new start. Feels very hermit energy, this energy, the angel of wisdom. Finding the knowledge, the answers from within, in how you need to move forward in your external environment. But there also could be some information coming into you, like this justice, maybe some decision that you're waiting for, that is just allowing you to make peace with the situation once and for all. Because we've got the Four of Pentacles and we have the Three of Swords. So sometimes the Four of Pentacles can be an energy of, it's been difficult to move on from something. And this Three of Swords can be to do with something that has caused you emotional pain. It can be some truth coming to light in relationships. It can be heartbreak. It can be third party situations. It can just be some truth that has hurt you deeply. Now that can be relationships in terms of personal relationships. That can be in terms of work relationships. That can be to do with friendships. Can even be to do with money areas as well. It's not limited to that, but you know, it might well be something has hurt you financially as well in a situation. I definitely feel for some of you, the message here is this wound is exposed to the elements. And remember, it's a three, and the three in tarot is all about manifesting something new. So even though this has caused you emotional pain, spirit is saying that you needed to see this truth in order to learn from the experience. It is Saturnian energy, and move on and grow as a person and break free of this, because this wound is exposed to the elements, and when a wound is exposed to the elements, it starts to heal, and the scars heal twice as strong. So I feel for some of you, Scorpio, whatever this pain is, you're ready to move on from it. The Eight of Swords in the challenge position can be about negative thoughts keeping you stuck. This can be if you focus on the negative, you'll only find more negativity. It can surround you. The mind can be your best friend or your worst enemy, and the Swords energy is to do with the mind. So, and again, I'm seeing that with the Three of Swords here. Whatever this hurt was, this can be where it can obsess you a little bit. And stop you from focusing on anything else. So the message with the Eight of Pentacles is you need to focus on what is going to bring you stability and security and safety into your life and growth and fulfillment. You know, the Pentacles energy can be our conscious reality. So it can be to do with our money, our career, can be to do with our home, can be to do with our foundational relationships, people that we rely on and build our lives around can also be to do with our health. So I definitely feel for some of you, you're being told to align now. And this is where the answers come from within. Align to bringing greater security, stability into your life. Because it feels for some of you that it's available to you, but it is a challenge position. This can be also about working through a situation, focusing on the practical things, maybe in terms of your money and career, maybe in terms of some skills development, which this can be, maybe, you know, can be to make you more attractive on the job market. It might well be focusing on just the practical things that you need to do to bring that feeling of working through a situation in a positive, constructive way. The devil, yes, I'm going to clarify this. Let's clarify this devil for Scorpio. What is this devil, please, angels? Okay, thank you. I've got two cards here. So I've got the card of Sagittarius, which is temperance, and I have the Six of Pentacles, clarifying this devil. So the devil can be about instability, can be in terms of any form of relationship. So could be in the workplace, can be in your personal life, can be to do with friendships. I mean, call it what you will. It is a card of imbalance, you know, it's a card of instability where something doesn't seem healthy anymore. The devil is a puppeteer, it's an illusion, it's a manipulator card, it's a card of feeling powerless in a situation. It definitely feels in this energy, it can be about shadow, it can be about an attachment that's difficult to break free of, it can be about addiction, it can be about feeling trapped, restricted, caught up in something that you know isn't good for you, you know? But here's the thing, the temperance card is here, clarifying this devil. Now, the temperance energy is where there's been imbalance, you're getting balance back into your life, you're making peace with the situation. Because sometimes these two cups are represented as water and fire, and when you mix water and fire together, they create steam. So it feels like you're making peace with something, you're cancelling something out. What or whoever this devil was, you're getting your head around the situation. And this person is staring at those three swords, the Three of Swords here. But the fourth sword is generally an energy of getting your head around a situation and understanding how you need to move forward. It's a card of re-strategizing and recovery. So in that energy, you're finding balance. And the message with the Six of Pentacles is put your energy in the right direction. Put your energy in what is going to bring you growth, stability, security, value, all of those kind of things in your life. Because when you do, it's linked with the law of attraction. That's when the universe rewards you in kind. This is an energy of giving and receiving. It's saying that you're going to get what you'll receive, and it's your time to receive now, Scorpio. So it feels like there's divine assistance around you. It can also be that maybe there's somebody around you who's helping you through a situation, talking you through it, giving you advice. Because I love these energies. What you are doing, you're rising above this and moving on. The Chariot leaves what's gone behind. You can see the village. He's not interested in what's gone now. He's pulling his life into balance, the yin and yang, you know, the black and white sphinxes are pulled into balance by the Chariot's actions here. So he can go in a straight line to a new victory, to a new goal, to a new success. This is willpower. Somebody who's taking their power back as well. It's an empowering energy. Somebody who's taking control of a situation that's controlled them because they've made peace with it. They're breaking free of the attachments, the fool, and their eyes on the prize towards a new goal. This is a powerful turning point for you, really. Scorpio, because the Chariot is a card of victory, success, overcoming challenge, and coming through the other side of it. It's a lovely, lovely energy of by your own actions and determinations, you are claiming a victory and success. And accepting an ending, it feels for some of you, the Eight of Cups is saying, well, it didn't work out in whatever energy this was, and I'm moving on. Death card is your card, Scorpio. It is about endings, change. But, you know, the Death card is transformation as well. It's an energy of, yes, I am closing this door. I am saying goodbye to whatever this situation is. I've made peace with it. I feel justice will be served here. And I am optimistic and so ready. I'm starting over. And I've got the answers from within in terms of where I'm going and what I'm doing. And, you know, I'm focusing my energies on bringing stability and security into my life. And, oh, interesting, the devil is underneath. Walking away from the devil, that has only made me feel lack. That has only made me feel powerless. Now I am rising in my own light and shedding an old skin and moving on from whatever this situation was. So it feels for some of you that there is a conclusion here. Something is concluding. Something is absolutely becoming clear, and you're walking away. Someone is saying goodbye, but it's an empowering energy of I am so optimistic and positive and energized and ready for the new. It's a lovely, lovely energy. Okay. Final message for Scorpio, please. Yeah. As if by magic, we have new beginnings. The Fool. Powerful new beginnings here. Beginning and end of your reading, you've got new beginnings. We have the Fairy of Godmother. The Fairy Godmother heralds the joyous news of a new baby or the birth of a cherished idea. Protect and nurture your ideas as you would a baby. Yeah, I love this energy. I really do. I definitely feel for some of you, you're just... Absolutely, there's a finality. You're closing this door. You are the Phoenix rising, and you are absolutely moving forward. I hope you enjoyed the reading. If you did, please do like, share, and subscribe. And I hope it's a wonderful week for you, Scorpio, and I will see you next time. Thank you.